have some exclusive pictures now showing how one of our outback wonders has suddenly burst back to life.
A driving force of nature pumping life back into the Menindee Lakes. The system not just full, but overflowing 105% of capacity.
It's magic. To see Menindee Lakes full is sometimes a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
The wildlife and wildlife lovers are returning.
Sure, they're breeding up.
The system's coming back.
The satellite view revealing the lake's parched location out near Broken Hill. Pre-COVID, it was a traveller's magnet. Now, only locals are keeping the home fires burning. Now, the Darling is positively gushing.
We are seeing flows into the Menindee Lakes that we haven't seen for a decade.
And local farmers want to make sure the lakes keep their supply.
We're trying to make some operational changes so we keep the water there longer.
The ongoing struggle of our outback oasis. Miley Hogan, 7 News.
Some good news. Yes, good news. Good pictures too. The Menindee Lake system in the far west of New South Wales has reached capacity for the first time in a decade. Today, the equivalent of 3 Sydney Harbours has filled the lake system and locals are over the moon, apparently. Melinda Pavey is the New South Wales Minister for Water and she joins me from Coffs Harbour on the mid-north coast. Minister, thank you very much for your time.
Oh, it's just magnificent. Those pictures are incredible. I was out there in April when we opened the gates with the community to let the water to start flowing in. So we've just had the most glorious rains through the Warrego, up into to Queensland, Western Queensland, through that very far western part of New South Wales. It's a picture, and just water is life out there for the communities to go fishing, to have fun, for the farmers. Just it's their tranquility, it's their place to have fun, and to see it full to the brim is really exciting.
And there's a little bit more to come, I hear.
Yeah, I mean, we've got La Nina predictions, really good rains for the next 12 months. I mean, we've got every dam full to overflowing in New South Wales. Wyangla Dam, it's been spilling for a couple of weeks. And, we've got the plans and we're doing all the homework to build that dam by an extra 650 gigalitres, also Dungowan Dam. And I think the message here is that, we're going to have, droughts continuing, and it's important that we don't take the foot off the throttle when it comes to planning the next series of dams so that we can manage climate change, those extra droughts, but those extra periods of heavy rainfall.